Welcome back, it's 2020. Let's take a look at the new update for today, which is a temperature probe. Let's get started! There's the temperature probe, that's the update for today, and nothing else. There's no bug fixes listed. So what this thing does is read the temperature in the area. So if you're in the snow, it reads it cold in Celsius degrees, and if you're, you know, in this nice tropical area, it's probably gonna read a little bit higher. And depending on the fog or the rain or whatever, it's gonna get a different temperature. And what you can do is hook this up to a heater with Lua or whatever, and turn it off and turn on in your vehicle, blah, blah, blah. You know, you get the idea. That's it. All right, let's get to the next thing. Alright, so here's what today's video is all about, which is a new release and tour. This is, let me get into camera mode. Alright, so here is the P-51D imported 3D object, and it gives us nice hints about the tail and the wings and the fuselage. So that's it, no big deal. Let's see what we did with it. Alright, so we took that 3D model after we imported and we brought it into the editor and we tweaked it and made it into a P-51B as in boy, not the D model. The B model has the canopy that slides open like this and it's not a bubble top, so you can't really see behind you. And so this is an older model and it's based on a real P-51 that is based on a real pilot's plane, and it's called the Old Crow. Can't remember the name of the guy. I think it's Bill or Bob. Don't remember. But this was his P-51 paint scheme and it's very cool. I like it. Turned out pretty well, but of course with Stormworks it has bugs. And I'm gonna go ahead and tell you about those bugs, and there's one right there. You can see it's sliding on the ground. So in order to get the wheels to work like a P-51, I had to build the wheels. Would you please stop moving just for 2 seconds? I had to build the wheels up. So when this plane spawns, the wheels come down and that stops the plane from flipping over in the air because there's a bug or whatever you want to call it, physics thing, where subassemblies with the new wheels or something freak out because of whatever scientific math things I don't know about. And so anyways, the idea is to reverse out that problem, I build the gear up, and then when the gear comes down, there's no bug that makes it flip over when you put them up in the air. However, the side effect is these wheels no longer roll. You're pretty much sliding on the ground. And so in order to counter that, I put a pivot on the back wheel and you have to turn with the back wheel and there are no brakes. So yeah. All right, so let's go ahead and get in here and test flight and show you what it's about. So we're gonna jump up on this corner. Just hold the space bar and you'll jump right on. There's no ladders or handles. And oops, there's a missing block there. Darn it, I'll have to fix that before I upload it. And so we're gonna get inside here and we're gonna go ahead and flip the canopy closed. And that's right up there. And then we also have nav lights, landing lights, and panel lights. But they're not gonna come on because I forgot to turn on the inverter. So let's turn on the inverter and there we go. Oh, we have a gun sight too. And if we look around, there are the lights looking nice and lovely. All right, cool. All right, let's turn these off before our battery goes dead. And we have a little light here, say stall warning. Now I need to fix that. I think I need to put something that says, you know, if you're on the ground, don't turn on this light. But let's go ahead and turn on the light here and check out the panels. So we have the inverters, which you turn on first. We have the generators, which you want to turn on the air later on. We have the landing gear button, we have the engine starter, and we have a limiter. This plane doesn't actually need the limiter, so that's really not useful. But since I was testing my easy plane component or whatever you want to call it, I went ahead and hooked everything up. And we have here prop pitch on the side and throttle on the left. You can use your arrow keys to do up and down on the throttle, which is nice. I always like that. And of course you can just click it too. So there you go. And let's put it back down to 15 right there. Cool. And we have on our side here, which is, if you look at the corner, we have the throttle setting, prop pitch setting, engine temp, RPS. On the bottom right, we have battery level in percent, 0 to 100. And we have the fuel, and we have altitude in feet, and speed in miles per hour. And then we have lights, fuel warning, battery warning, temp warning, and down there is landing gear? No, that's landing gear. What is this one for? What is that for? Oh, brakes. That's what it's for. There we go, brakes. But the brakes really only are working on this back wheel, so brakes are kind of irrelevant, but that's number 4 on the keyboard. So yeah. So we'll go ahead and ignore that for right now and go ahead and turn on the engine. Ooh, there it goes. And this plane is pretty easy to take off. You can go about 40. And let's just watch it take off. I'm not touching anything. It's going to go ahead and take off. Oops, I did touch the elevator there. It's very sensitive on the elevator. But you can adjust that in the settings if you want to turn it down. I just have it up really high pitched because I was testing things and the landing gear was driving me crazy. Now watch this. So if I go ahead and raise the landing gear, nothing is going to happen this bad. So that's a nice feature. I know. A plane. Now look at that. It goes up. Nice, huh? Just like the real P-51. So that is it for today. I just wanted to go ahead and get something out for the beginning of 2020 and something that is relatively stable. And this plane flies really nice. We can go ahead and open up the canopy and see here. You can just fly around the island and look at everything. Ooh, this is neat. Look at that. The multiplayer island is right next to the creative island. Pretty cool. Okay, I think that's it. Should I try landing this thing? As, you know, like my final scene. So we are lining up. I know that about 20 is my cutoff point. Whoa, I am really high. But this is my cutoff point. 20 is about my cutoff point for the plane to kind of start stalling down. So if you're going to land, oh, I'm rising too low. Let me bump it up a little bit. But 20 is kind of the magic number for landing, I think. I can't say. All right, there we go.
Look at this. I landed. Oh, no, he didn't. Yes, he did. No, he didn't. Kind of did. Sort of did. Maybe not. Yeah.
There we go. Well, let's turn off the engine quick. I'm going to call that a landing. Oh, no, wait, I broke the thing. Anyways. All right, well, that's it for today. You can go ahead and download this on the workshop and give it a try. Let me know what you think. You can also download the 109 if you haven't done so already, and it is updated with a new engine. Thanks to the Golden Warden and Darth Dog, who updated the cooling system and the gearbox on there. So it flies a bit better now with the single prop or the...
What do you call it? Double prop. Double prop? Single blade. Two blade. Whew. The double blade.
Right? Yes. The double blade. Alright, so go have some fun with this plane, and I will see you next time. If you haven't done so already, go ahead and hit the bell, so it goes ding dong.
Can I do it again?
Ding dong. When I upload a new video, and if you haven't done so already, please consider subscribing, and I will see you next time.
Bye! We're not gonna take off, it's broken.